The rapture and the second coming, are they both biblical? Is there a difference? Are there signs that point to both? That is coming up shortly. This is Pastor Greg Tipton. Thank you for joining me right here on New Life Today. We are going to take a look at two subjects in the scripture that have garnered many questions, many interpretations, and many thoughts. And that is the rapture of the church and the second coming. Now, we're not going to try to place dates because the scripture tells us that we do not know. Not even the Son of Man knows. The Father has that in his keeping. But what we are going to do is we are going to look at if both of them are in the Bible, if there is a difference between them, and are there any signs that are following? Let's kind of work backwards. When it comes to signs for both, one of the things that we have to establish is that when it comes to the rapture of the saints of God, that is the catching away of those who are looking for Christ to come back for them, the saints of God, the first thing that we establish is that there are no particular signs or specific biblical prophecies that need to be fulfilled before that catching away comes to pass. In other words, every prophecy, everything that's there has already been fulfilled. That time is an imminent time. It was actually a time in which the apostles thought it could happen even in their own lifetime as far as the rapture. And so we understand there's not any signs particularly towards the rapture. However, having said that, one of the best ways to describe or to give a picture of how we look for the rapture is much like, think about Thanksgiving and Christmas. I heard a preacher tell this and it cleared up a lot of things for me. Think of the holiday seasons of Christmas and Thanksgiving. You can liken the rapture to Thanksgiving and the second coming to Christmas. And here's what I mean by that. There are many signs that will precede the second coming of Christ. And you see those. And it's kind of like Christmas that way. We see long before Christmas gets here, the lights go up, the songs come out, the cheerful spirit and everything of that anticipated holiday is beginning to come to the front. However, there is a holiday that we don't pay much attention to, and that is Thanksgiving that happens in November every year. But what we are seeing is we see the signs of Christmas coming, which tells us this, that Thanksgiving is even closer than that. Same way with the rapture and with the second coming. We see the signs. Remember, prophecy always casts a shadow before it. And so we see the signs and the shadows of the second coming. So that would tell us as it's approaching is closer and closer, then that tells us that the coming or the rapture of the church, the rapture of the saints, is even closer than when we first believed or heard about it. But let's take a look at what the scripture has to say. Are they both biblical? They are. The rapture of the church in the scripture, we find a very clear picture of it written by the Apostle Paul in 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 through 18. Here's what he says. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as indeed the rest of mankind do who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died, rose from the dead, so also God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep through Jesus. For we say this to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain at the coming of the Lord will not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who remain, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. So we find that the Apostle Paul gives us a picture. We find that it is imminent, and we also find that it is different than the second coming of Jesus Christ. Paul tells us that we are caught up. The term caught up means that we are seized, we're carried by force. Means that there is a seize on us, there is a claim for oneself eagerly to catch up, to seize and to take away. And so Jesus has eagerly claimed his believers for themselves. We see another picture of this by Jesus himself. In John chapter 14, verse 1 through 3, we read this, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms," or mansions as the Authorized Version says. "If that were not so, I would have told you, because I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I am coming again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you also will be." To take or to receive means to take with oneself or to join oneself. I'm going to stop and talk here for just a moment about something that is very interesting when we deal with this particular verse of Scripture and what we look at. There is something called the marriage supper of the Lamb. This is where all of the saints of God that have been caught up, raptured out, whatever term you want to use, is now seated with Christ at the marriage supper of the Lamb in heaven. Now, the marriage supper of the Lamb, or the marriage supper of an individual, lasted for one full week. That was 7 days. What they would do is when the courtship or the betrothal process was done, the husband-to-be would go back to the father's house. He would prepare a place for his bride, so that where he was, there she could be also. And the father would inspect that. And then there would come that day when the father would say, "It's good enough. Go get your bride. Bring her unto yourself." And then they would go, and for 7 days, they would spend time together at the marriage festival, the marriage feast. This is a picture of that. At the marriage supper of the Lamb, we will be with him for 7 years. Here's the reason why I say that. It's because when you read the book of Daniel, you understand that 1 week is symbolic of a year. And so he says to him that there will be a time and times and a half of time. And he gives us the understanding of how to break down that time. So the 1 week equals 7 years in the Scripture as far as Revelation goes. So for that 7-year period, we will be at the marriage supper of the Lamb. We will be caught up and taken so that where he is, we are also there with him. He takes with oneself or joins oneself. He's coming back for his bride. It is an imminent experience, which means it could happen at any point. It doesn't mean when he says he's coming soon that it means in time frame. It means that it could happen immediately and that we would be caught. The rapture is for those who have fallen asleep, both those who have fallen asleep or died in Christ, and for those who are alive in Christ. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Let's look at it again. "But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who are asleep." Paul is writing to the church here in Thessalonica that has been told that they have missed the day of the Lord, or that they were living through the tribulation. And Paul tells them, listen, you've not missed it. For those who are asleep, those who have died in Christ will be resurrected at his coming for his church. And then Paul goes on to say, then we who are alive and who remain will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so will always be with the Lord. Now here's a beautiful thing about that verse of scripture is the closeout in verse 18 when he says, comfort one another with these words. The rapture, the catching away of the saints, the resurrection of those who have died and fallen asleep in Christ, there is a hope that we will be reunited and we are to comfort one another with that fact. The rapture is Christ's coming to the earth. It is not his physical appearance. It is his being suspended between heaven and earth, and those who are looking for him will be caught up. The Apostle Paul once again said, we will be caught up to be with him. In 2 Timothy, Paul said, there is in the future laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have loved his appearing. That term love there means to entertain or to be fond of or to love dearly. In other words, they're entertaining the fact that Christ is going to return for them. There are so many beautiful analogies that we can use in Scripture, and our time is beginning, as the Apostle Paul, or as the writer of Hebrews would say, beginning to fail us of what we'd be able to explain to you. Again, these videos are just short, concise videos. I give you Scripture and share with you, and pray and hope that it will encourage you to go and research the matter, to be like the Bereans that heard the word, but then they went and researched it, studied it, and they learned what the Word of God said for themselves. I want to thank you for joining me. We're going to cover the second coming on another video, so we'll want you to stay tuned. And until then, I'm praying for you, and God bless you.